Good morning, Todd Mina here live at Fire Station 30 here in the Glenville neighborhood of Cleveland. It's Chef Kwan's Kitchen.
Hey.
That's what we're going to call the segment, Chef Kwan's Kitchen.
Chef Kwan, cooking with Kwan.
I love it.
We'll
I love it. Gordon Kwan, nice to meet you.
Thanks for being here and helping us out.
We really enjoy that we get this peek inside the life of a firefighter and what you guys do.
It's not often it happens that people get an opportunity to come inside these doors. Not that we don't welcome everyone,
right?
But it gives you a chance to see how we actually live and how we actually have to do the job, but right. also work with each other.
Because this is your house.
This is basically it.
You know, it's your second home.
Every third day of your life, you're here. You're here actually awake, more awake hours with these guys, these firefighters, these women, everybody that's on the job, more than you are with your own family.
And being part of that, you got to cook. Meals are a big part of that. And when it's Chef Kwan's shift, he's the chef. Nobody else is allowed in the kitchen.
Nobody's allowed in the kitchen.
So you're making some ribs today, and these are sticky ribs?
Absolutely. These are sticky ribs. We've already gone ahead. We've put them on the smoker.
Yeah.
They've come off of that smoker. We made our braising liquid. We're going to take that braising liquid that you make. We're going to smother those ribs in that braising liquid. Now, if you do a rack, a two-rack, I know the recipe calls for two racks. Just get that braising liquid on there. We would cover this. Take that, we're gonna put that in the oven.
Why do you separate the ribs instead of cooking a whole rack at a time?
It enables two things.
Yeah.
One, it enables that all of that sauce and that braising liquid to get in there, helps to tenderize them just a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And then also, makes it a lot easier when you go to get them out and plate them. You don't have sticky ribs and you're trying to cut them and make it
and they're always, a lot of times they're tough to cut when they're cooked like that, too.
Absolutely.
To get a nice rib section.
To get a nice rib section, to get a little too soft, a little too tender.
How long are we with the braising liquid?
We're going to be in the braising liquid 1 hour, 350.
And you smoked them for 2 hours?
2 hours on the smoke.
Okay.
1 hour. If you don't have smoke, grill them.
Yeah.
If you don't have the ability to grill, put them in the braising liquid for 3 hours. You'll be fine.
Okay, good.
You can go straight from raw. You'll be great.
Love that. Through the magic of television, we got...
Magic of TV.
Look at that.
We open this bad boy up, and ta-da!
Ta-da!
We have some that's already there.
And looks, you know they're good because they pulled away from the bone like that.
Absolutely. Those things are going to pull away from the bone. Once we take this out of here, we would take this. We would separate these from the fluid. All right, all your liquid, we would strain that.
Yeah.
All right, get all those solids.
Because that's good. You don't want.
Oh, you don't want to lose this.
All the pork
this
in there.
This is what you're going to. Yeah, we're going to take that. We put it in a pot just like this. Now, this is the money. We put it on here.
Yeah.
Throw it on the stove, get that going. Once that stove heats up, we have.
Got a little cornstarch and make a little slurry for that, thicken it up, right?
Cornstarch, water. Here's a trick. Head over to your Asian store, maybe over 30th and Payne.
Go to Asia Town.
Plaza, Asia Town Center over on Superior. Get yourself some tapioca starch. Works a lot better.
Oh, than cornstarch?
Much faster, much better.
So we thicken up the sauce. Now you got that glaze that you really want.
Beautiful glaze that you got going on. While we were doing that, thickening that sauce, what we did is we had these ribs here in the braiser or in the broiler.
And you're just kind of caramelizing that sauce, kind of drying it out.
Up. Yeah. You see that? Oh, yeah. Look at that. Those are looking good there. Getting those good. We'll keep that down.
How long have you been cooking here?
I've been cooking here at this station for 27 years.
Man.
Going on my 30th year on the job. So.
That's amazing. And are you making the recipes for everybody? You come up with a meal plan? Because you got to cook what the guys want to eat.
You know what? A good cook in a firehouse doesn't have to be a great cook. Yeah. You need to know what everybody likes to eat.
Right.
If a guy doesn't like onions, I won't cook the onions.
Right.
All right. If a guy doesn't like cream or can't eat cream, don't cook the cream.
Sure, because you got to deal with that. Allergies or food imperfections.
Because all in all, deep down inside, what you truly want is participation. Mm-hmm. All right. We are a family, and part of us being able to depend on each other, brothers and sisters, is being able to sit down, eat with one another, talk, laugh, joke.
Because that bond forms, and it makes it easier to do the job because you have the team already formed.
Absolutely.
So, all right, these are out. These are to look amazing, by the way.
Oh, my goodness. So we're going to get these.
So.
We take these guys. All right, take a couple of them off of here.
By the way, this recipe is going to be on our website. And Chef Kwan did have to figure out what the actual amounts were because a lot of times you don't cook with specifics. You
almost
eyeball it,
no recipes. Right? Just cooking my eyeball.
So go to fox8.com. You know? You can see these this sticky rib recipe.
Yeah, that rib recipe you got on there will work out just fine for you. Okay, we're going to take these over here. We're going to throw them on a plate. Actually, Todd, if you can move that one. Oh, it's a little hot. Be careful. Slide
it
over.
All good.
Fantastic.
Nothing like heat at the fire station.
You know.
By the way, again, the recipe's on our website, fox8.com. I'd like to thank everybody out here. Chief Gorski, Lieutenant Norman as well, Chef Kwan. Let us come inside, see a little bit of that, what we have here at Fire Station 30.
A little of that.
The best ladder company.
A little of this.
Oh, boom. I like that. Can I get it a little try?
Yeah, absolutely.
Because I got to eat that. Let me take a taste. Oh, man. Oh, that's nice. That glaze is beautiful.
That's a good thing.
Hear the soy and the hoisin coming through on that? Oh, that's awesome.
Hot, steamy goodness.
Mm. Oh, man.
All right, I'm going to lick my fingers, send it back to you guys.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you.
Check that recipe out at fox8.com.
He called it
hot. Thank you so much.
He called it hot, steamy goodness.
Yeah.
There you go.
We'll try that.
Come on now.
Oh, that looks good.
Yeah, it does. Mm.